Hey everyone, Susan Black here, and I'm in my car. You got to take the opportunities when you can, and I'm coming to you live outside of the barber shop. And I dropped Pete off to get a haircut. He has been harassing me for a while. When are you going to take me for a haircut? When are you going to take me for a haircut? And that's just kind of part of, I think, today's Facebook Live is, what is it like to have a spouse with Alzheimer's disease? And you just have to go with the flow. Your life is no longer your life. It is very similar to having, some days it's similar to having a toddler. Some days it's similar to having an adolescent. It's no longer the life that you had before. It's not like having the life that you have with your spouse. It's totally different. Pete, like I said, I dropped him off to get a haircut because it's like having a teenager. I can't go in there with him. He told me I can drop him off, I can give him the money, but he said, "Mommy, I don't want the other boys to know that I can't drive anymore. So you can stay out in the parking lot, you can stay out in the car, but you can't come in with me anymore." So I'm out here in the parking lot and I'm coming to you live just to kind of share some of the different things. I took him to get his eye appointment today too, and I had to share with the eye doctor that he has Alzheimer's because, you know, when they ask you the questions, is it better number one or number two? He has issues with that. I mean, we all have issues with that. So the eye doctor was really good with him and was patient, and we discussed the fact that, like, the last time he had progressive lenses, and he doesn't understand, you know, how to use, like, the bifocal lens part and what that's for. So we have to go through different things. But I had a lady in church who came up to me and she asked me, she said, "Susan, you know, Pete does so well, nobody would know that he has Alzheimer's." And that's true. He does do really well. He can cover it really well. And you're not with us at home. You're not with me with the 800,000 questions. Even though I write things on the calendar, you know, what are we doing today? Where are we going next? Like I said, it's like having a toddler in the house or an adolescent in the house. Where are we going next? What are we doing now? That type of thing. So he covers really well. I also am there for him. He relies constantly on me. And that's what I'm there for. I'm his spouse. We kind of refer to me as kind of like his seeing eye dog. Sometimes it's irritating because it's like he shadows me. He follows me around everywhere. But that's what I'm there for. He relies on me, and I know that. But because of that, I never get a break. He's there constantly, and even if I do go somewhere, I worry about leaving him at home. Not that he's gotten into any sort of trouble or anything like that, but sure enough, I went out shopping and last Sunday, and when I got home, boy, you were gone a long time. And I knew that was going to happen. So it's really hard to even get out and enjoy yourself. But we did get to the point now where we are sleeping in separate bedrooms. That was a big step after being married for 35 years, but I no longer could sleep well. I'm not at the point where I'm worried about him leaving the house at any point yet. He does wander around the bedroom a little bit, trying to find the bathroom, but he's pretty good about still being able to find the bathroom. But I would lay awake at night waiting for him to wander. And so we did move to separate bedrooms. He would wake up at night wondering who I was. Sometimes he would wake up at night and he would just stare at me, or he would touch me, touch my face, trying to figure out who I was. A couple times he pulled my hair and I just could not sleep. So we did move to separate bedrooms, and that has helped some. So that's a big change. Of course, intimacy is gone because the relationship has changed. It's different, like I said, when a relationship becomes like a toddler relationship or an adolescent relationship. He's my spouse. I love him. We've been married for 35 years. You take your vows in sickness and in health, and we are in that point in our relationship. But he does cover it really well. He's still my husband, and we did do a clinical trial for 2 years, and there was a slight benefit during that time, but we are just taking, letting the natural progression of the disease happen. We are trying to enjoy our journey and making the best of everything, but I'm not going to sugarcoat everything. I'm not going to let people think, because when I come live, you know, Pete and I will do these things together, and we'll laugh and we'll joke, but I want to be real with everybody, because I used to follow somebody on Facebook. The gentleman had Alzheimer's himself, and everything was great with him. He was showing all these things where he was having a great time, but it gives a false sense of what Alzheimer's is, and especially what early onset Alzheimer's is. And I feel like my mission is to educate people about this disease, because unless people know what this disease is, we're not going to get the research and the funding that we need to help stop this disease, because it's affecting more and more younger people. It's affecting people in their 30s. It's devastating families. Families are going bankrupt because of the disease. We're fortunate in the fact that Pete works for the federal government. So when he retired, he was able to stay and keep his health insurance. Now, he would have been fast-tracked with Medicare having this diagnosis, which would have been great for him, but I would have been left without any health insurance. But because he was able to stay on the federal health insurance, I was able to stay with health insurance myself so that I could stay at home to take care of him. But if I wasn't able to stay on health insurance, I would have either had to go without any health insurance, or I would have had to continue to work and either leave him at home without any help, or we would have gone bankrupt because I would have had to spend money to pay for somebody to take care of him. And that's what's happening with a lot of families. This is financially ruining families, and people aren't aware of that. It's a devastating disease, not only physically, mentally, but financially, and people aren't aware of that. This disease affects everybody, and we need to get people to be aware of that. People have wondered how my children feel about me going out and talking about it. And I'll be honest, my daughter really doesn't like me to be vocal and to talk about these things. But if I don't talk about it, how is anybody going to be aware of it? As you can see, Pete's fine with it. I don't make him come on live with me and talk about this. He's the one who will come on and say, I'll say, hey, I'm going to do a Facebook Live. He's like, okay, what are we going to talk about today? He's completely fine with it. He's fine. And I feel like it's a legacy. I feel like it's a legacy for our children and our grandchildren to see these videos in the future of their grandfather, of his younger days when he was able to share stories. I feel like it's so important. So, is Alzheimer's easy? Absolutely not. But you have to share those little moments of joy. You have to find the positive in all the moments you can. So here I'm sitting in the car like I used to when our kids were younger, when I would drop them off at the orthodontist's office or to get their hair cut. I'm doing it again. Now I'm doing it with my husband. I'm reliving those teenage years. I'm sitting in the parking lot of the barber shop while my husband gets his hair cut because he didn't want mommy to come inside because he didn't want the boys to know he couldn't drive anymore. So I'm enjoying these little moments of quiet time. I'm sitting in the barbershop parking lot while my honey gets his hair cut. So I'm enjoying the moments of quiet. I'm hoping that you're enjoying your journey. I'm trying to enjoy mine. So until we meet again, remember to enjoy your journey.